Hello, boys and girls. Hello, students. Teacher Mark from Sanshui Foreign Languages School, BFSU. I'm going to teach you science today. And it will be, we'll review Unit 2. We'll review whole unit. The unit new plants. Previously I taught you wind pollination, bee pollination, parts of flowers, and growing new plants. So let's review all these things. Please watch carefully, listen carefully, speak loudly, and let's go. Unit review. The book is, I remind you, the book is Light Up Science, grade 4. And we do unit review. Question 1. Which plants are pollinated by bees? Repeat after me. Which plants are pollinated by bees? Read together with me. Yeah. Which plants are pollinated by wind? Which plants are pollinated by wind? Draw lines. You know, I taught you, there is bee pollination and there is wind pollination. You can see here in a green cloud, by bees, pollinated by bees. And in pink cloud, in a pink cloud, by wind, pollinated by wind. So, which plants? We can see some grassy plants like this, like corn, some, I don't know what kind of, I'm not sure what kind of plant is this, but look grassy, very simple, small flowers. And we have here beautiful sunflower with big yellow flowers, and here is beautiful red flowers. I'm not sure the name. Okay, so which plants are pollinated by bees? Number one, which plant pollinated by bee or by wind? This plant is pollinated by wind. That's right, because it is grassy plant, look like grass. So, this plant, sunflower, pollinated by bees, of course, because it's big, yellow, colorful, bees can see, can smell, and fly. Okay, to pollinate it, right? Okay, so what about red flowers? Of course, bees pollinated. Yeah, by bees, this flowers, beautiful flowers with nice smell, they pollinated by bees. Mm-hmm. And this corn plant is pollinated, the corn plant is pollinated by wind. Wind blew in the pollen. Okay, good job. Let's go number two. Number two, some practice. Okay, let's put myself here closer to you. Okay, so number two, this is practice growing a new plant. So Mary made a new plant from a cutting. What is the order? What is the order? Letters order, right? Write the letters here in these squares. Okay, so Mary, she made a cutting, right? Obviously, this is C, right? She made a cutting. Okay, and this is C, yeah! Okay, number two, what she has to do with this cutting, what she has to do? Of course, put it in soil. You can see here the, okay, the, this bucket, whatever. Okay, and she, and here is soil, and so she put it in soil, and this is D, yes. Okay, so what do plants need for life? What do they need to live? Right, so they need soil, yes, they need soil, they need some space to live, they need some air to breathe, they need sunlight or just light, any kind of light. So soil, air, space, and water. Yes, and water, same like humans, same like we are. Okay, so water, give the plant some water. Please give plant some drink. Okay, so this is B, right? Okay, and we can see a new plant from tiny, a little cutting. We can see a big plant with many leaves, right? And this is A. So C, D, B, A. Here you go. Okay, so Mary made a new plant from a cutting. Workbook. Let's do some work. Not only learning, we need to do some work. Of course, we learn when we work when we learn. Okay, so practice the words. Practice the words. Number one, what are the parts of the flower? What are the parts of the flower? Draw lines. So, we know parts of the plant. And particularly parts of the plant is a flower, right? And three main parts of the flower are here in green cloud. Anther. Pistil in an orange cloud. And the pink cloud, we have here sign, petal, and let's see, anther is a male part of the flower, boys part of the flower, male part, and anthers are yellow here, right? Here you go, yellow is anther, okay? What is the green one? Yes, this is a pistil. Pistil is a female part of a flower, a girl part of a flower, okay? Girly part, okay? Girl, woman. Female, okay, and the petal is the most beautiful part of the flower, and there are petals, they are the color, beautiful purple color. Okay, very good, there are parts of the flower. This flower we call a perfect flower. a perfect flower. Why do we call this flower a perfect flower? Perfect flower. Why? Because this flower has male and female parts, both together. Some plants have only anthers, some flowers, they have only male or only female. This flower has both male and female parts of the flower. That's why we call it perfect flower. Okay, let's go next. Number two. We need to complete the sentences. Complete the sentences. To complete the sentences, we need to write the numbers, correct numbers in these blanks. Okay, so number one, pollen. Number two, pollination. Number three, wind pollination. So let's see this beautiful purple flower we just saw it previously at the previous picture. And now we can see again, we can see yellow anthers there, right? And the bee seeds there. So bees help to pollinate flowers. Bees help to pollinate flowers. This is called, that's right, pollination. This is called pollination, number two. Pollinate flowers is pollination. The next picture here. Wind can blow to pollinate. What is pollination? When pollen gets from one flower to another, from male flower to female flower. That's the pollination, right? When pollen gets from one flower to another, from one plant to another plant. Okay, so wind can blow pollen. Yes, wind can blow pollen, number one. Yes, this is called wind can blow pollen, means wind pollination, and this is number three. Okay, grassy flower usually use wind pollination. Okay, so let's read these sentences again using words from these boxes. Bees help to pollinate flowers together. Bees help to pollinate flowers. This is called pollination. Wind can blow pollen. This is called wind pollination. Okay, very good. Next page. Stinking flowers. What are stinking flowers? Stinking flowers, many, let's read together. Many flowers use a nice smell to attract insects such as bees. Insects such as bees and, I would say, butterflies. So bees and butterflies smell nice smell. See beautiful big flowers. Bright colors, very beautiful. So and they fly to pollinate these flowers. But some flowers stink. They smell no good. They smell like bad meat. But some insects like it. So what insects like bad meat? What insects pollinate these flowers? And this flower maybe is beautiful red, but it stinks. It smells very, very, very bad. So what insects pollinate? I suggest flies and mosquitoes. They pollinate these stinking flowers. And the answer is flies like bad meat. Flies pollinate these flowers. I would say mosquitoes do the same. Okay. So and let's take a look. This video shows us bee pollination. Okay, so let's do some pollination video, bee pollination. Okay. Oops. Yeah. Okay, this is melon wine. Winter melon wine. That's the name of the flower. And we can see here anthers. Yeah, these yellow things we call anthers. And this is male flower. Male flower. M-A-L-E. I always say male. It's not the male like male, you said letter. Is a male like a man, okay? Male flower. Squash bees at male flower. Male flower, because these things we call anthers, okay? What bees doing there? These bees attracted to flower, but by its vibrant color, beautiful, bright, vibrant color, and sugar-rich nectar. Nectar is a very sweet, very yummy drink. This is food for bees and butterflies. Are they looking for? They're looking for nectar and pollen. Pollen is all over anthers here. Pollen, that like a dust, right? Like a powder. And bees drink nectar and collect pollens near their legs. Here, near their legs, some. On their backs, head, everywhere, on their wings. Yeah, but mostly, yes, on the stomach. Another one. Lunchtime! Alright, there you go. They drink. They're yummy, very yummy. They love nectar. They love to eat, actually drink, right? Okay. So, and pollen glue to their stomachs. And, yeah. They drink, and sometimes you see too much fall down because too much drink. Oh, they lose balance. They lose balance sometimes. But They lose balance, then get up and come back to drink again. They like it very much, even get inside when they're looking, in search of nectar deep inside the flower, between anthers. Okay, maybe no more. Okay, let's fly to another flower. Another flower. And another flower can be male or female flower. And if bees fly to the female flower and land it on it, then the pollen glue to the pistil, and that's it, and pollination happens, right? Okay, so squash bees at female flower. So again, looking for nectar, but pollen glue to the pistil. This is a pistil. So pollens, so they deposit pollen here. Okay. And pollination happens. They deposit pollen on the pistil, and that's it. Pollination happens. They deposit pollens from male into female flower. And then, the new flower happens. The bee washes its hands. Job is done. Goodbye. And our lesson is over. The job is done. And so, please view this video again. Repeat the words, read sentences, write the words in your notebooks, memorize them, and take care of yourself. Wash your hands, wear your mask, stay healthy, take care, take it easy. Bye bye, see you next time.